Madam Chair, I regret that what I am about to say could have been and was said a year ago. Not much has changed, but more lives have been destroyed and more billions of dollars have been wasted, all to no intelligent purpose.
This is the longest war in America's history, claiming thousands of lives, costing hundreds of billions of dollars, and the majority simply doesn't want to talk about it. We must talk about this war.
I have Camp Lejeune Marine Base in my district. I have signed over 10,474 letters to families who've lost loved ones since we were lied to go into Iraq.
It is not the job of the men and women who serve in the U.S. military to build nation states in Afghanistan. That policy was failed militarily. That policy is unsustainable economically. That policy does not make us more secure.
It is time for the United States to stop spending more in a month in Afghanistan than it would cost to hire every man and woman in Afghanistan of working age. That's what we're spending. You could rent the country for a year for what we're spending for a month.
Afghanistan is its own sovereign country, and its citizens need to take responsibility for their destiny. As for us, we need to bring our troops home and to start reinvesting in America.
And what's the cost here at home? How many cops could we have put on the beat? How many homes could have been saved from foreclosure? How many farmers could get drought relief? How many small business jobs could have been created? How many more patients could we have cared for at our veterans' hospitals?
This $88.5 billion should be directed immediately to rebuild the roads and bridges of this nation. In America, according to Transportation for America, we have 69,000 structurally deficient bridges. In New York State alone, we have over 2,000 structurally deficient bridges.
We face real and ongoing challenges from terrorist groups around the world. But after 10 years of fighting, it is clear that ongoing military presence in Afghanistan is simply not the answer.
And, you know, then they say, well, we're fighting for freedom. Think about it seriously. How in the world is going over there and fighting in Iraq or Afghanistan have anything to do with our freedom? Oh, we're fighting to defend our Constitution. Well, we never had a constitutional declaration of war.
We passed the sad milestone of 2,000 American lives lost in Afghanistan. Tens of thousands suffer more from wounds, both visible and invisible. And as we remember and honor our dead and our wounded and pray for their families and their loved ones, we also have the duty and responsibility and opportunity to act today to ensure that further losses are avoided and that we accelerate the transition to Afghans ruling Afghanistan.
I came out while I was shaving and I looked at the television. It was a beautiful family, a young man and a young woman and their child. And they announced that he had just been hit with an IED and lost both arms and both legs. And I was thinking, what a tragedy for this young man and for his family and the horrible things they're going to have to endure throughout the rest of their lives.
After 11 years, over 2,000 Americans killed, 16,000 Americans wounded, nearly $400 billion spent, and more than 12,000 Afghan civilians dead since 2007, we have to question the U.S. presence in Afghanistan.
Why are we in this predicament? Why are we even discussing $88 billion and perhaps hundreds, if not thousands, of more American lives being sacrificed halfway around the world?
And it's the fault of Congress. We approve the money and we remain silent year after year after year. We need to stop. We aren't supporting our troops. We're committing them to suffer lifelong trauma from too many deployments for too long a time, over too many years, for a war without end, for a war that always needs just a little more time and just a few billion dollars more. Enough is enough. I urge my colleagues to support amendments over the next 3 days to reduce the funding for this war, bring it to an end, and honor the sacrifice of our troops by bringing them and our tax dollars back home.